Hello, embedded system lovers. Have you ever wondered how your phone knows when to light up? I mean your mobile phone, how it knows when to light up, or how your microwave counts down, or how a sensor knows when to trigger an alarm? Well, it all begins with something small yet so powerful. Welcome to the world of logic gates, the brain behind every decision in embedded systems. Before logic gate, let's talk about binary digits. Bi means two. Binary digit means zeros and one. Zero here means low value. It also means false. It also means off. One means high. It means truth. It means on. High, truth, on. And every computer runs on binary digits, zeros and one. And this leads us to Boolean algebra. In Boolean algebra, we use binary digits. And one plus one here means one. So you can see why. 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. Why? Because there are no other digits, just zeros and 1. So when you learn this basic concept, you can easily learn Boolean algebra, which will further help in building your understanding about logic gates. For example, consider addition of binary digits in Boolean algebra. We know that 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, 1 plus 0 is equal to 1, and 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, not 2. Secondly, consider multiplication of binary digits in Boolean algebra. Remember that 0 and multiplication, 0 times 9999 is equal to hydrogen bomb. What that means is it finishes everything. So, everything like 0 into 0 is equal to 0. 0 times 1 is equal to 0. 1 times 0 is equal to 0, but 1 times 1 is equal to 1. So just remember that in Boolean algebra, all the mathematical operations are the same except 1 that is equal to 1. Now, if you want to learn logic gates, you must learn Boolean algebra. Without it, you cannot learn a single concept of logic gates. Hence, I will teach you some basic concepts of Boolean algebra. First, let me teach you addition of binary digits. Now, addition of binary digits, where A is equal to 0, A is equal to 1. So A plus 1 is what? Is equal to 1. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. A plus 0 is equal to A. And 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. Then 1 plus 0 is equal to what? 0. So that's for the addition of binary digits. Now, the next concept to learn is the multiplication of binary digits. So let's see how to multiply binary digits, where A is equal to 0 and A is equal to 1. So A times 1 is equal to A, 0 times 1, and remember what we said about multiplication with regards to zero and how it equates to bomb. That's the same thing with the multiplication of binary digits. Let's learn the concept of inverse in Boolean algebra. For example, consider a low value. If I ask you what is the opposite of that low value, your answer is pretty simple. The opposite is high value. We already know that zero represents low value and one represents high value from our understanding of binary digits. So from that understanding, the inverse of 0 is 1. Now, when we have one binary digit to be A, its inverse is A bar. Alright? So just remember that bar on any variable represents inverse value in Boolean algebra. Alright? So that's the basic concept of the inverse in Boolean algebra. So for an example where we have A equal to 0 and A equal to 1, 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, and A bar, the inverse of A, is equal to what? A. Now, let's understand the easy concepts of logic gates. But first, let's understand the basic purpose of a gate. So consider an open door and a closed door, as you can see on screen. In the case of the open door, you are allowed to pass through. But in the case of the closed door, you are not allowed to pass through. So similarly, consider these as logic gates. So logic gates either allow or do not allow electrical signal to pass through. And logic gates that allows electrical signals to pass through is on an on state. But when it blocks signal, it means it's off. So as you can see on screen, there are two logic gates here. One is on that allows signal to pass through to give a high output, and the other one is off that blocks signal, that is not allowing a signal to pass through it. Now, what are logic gates? Well, consider this logic gate. We give two inputs and we get one output. For example, I give 1 and 1 as inputs. And we know that 1 represents on, and this logic gate will give us an output of 1, as you can see on screen. So it allows data signal to pass through. Secondly, consider this other logic gate. I give 2 inputs to it, 0 and 0. We know that 0 represents off. This logic gate will give us 0 as output. So it does not allow data signal to pass through. Thus, when we give inputs to a logic gate, it performs Boolean function and it gives us an output. Therefore, we define logic gates as digital devices which perform Boolean functions by taking 2 inputs and giving 1 output. Here are a few things to remember. You must remember that logic gate works on the principle of Boolean algebra. And secondly, logic gates are made up of diodes and transistors. And you must also remember that with the help of Boolean algebra, logic gates either allow or block signals in order to enter into a circuit. So they either allow or they block signal in digital circuit. Now that we've understood that logic gates are the fundamental building blocks of all digital electronics, that they either take 1 or more inputs, either 0 or 1, and produce a single binary output. These are the various types of logic gates that we have. We have the basic logic gates, we have the universal logic gates. Alright, so the basic logic gate is the AND, OR, and the NOT. And then we have the universal logic gates, which is the NAD and NOR. And we also have the special gates, which is the XOR and the XNOR. So primarily we have 5 universal logic gates. And then we have these 2 extra that are the special gates. And we have the 3 basic gates. So these are the logic gate symbols. And we'll dive right into the 3 basic logic gates. Let's talk about one of the basic logic gates, the NOT gate. In digital logic, the NOT gate, which is also the inverter, is a logic gate that implements logical negation. It outputs the opposite of the bit that is put into it, as you can see on screen. So if the input is 0, the output will be 1. If the output is 1, the input will be 0. This is a NOT gate demonstrated using transistor. NOT gate using transistor works similar as NOT gate when you are using switch. So we need 1 input device and 1 output device that are button and LED, as you can see on screen. So initially, when the button is open circuited, that is when it's not pressed, transistor would not allow the signal to pass through the emitter of the transistor. So the only path remaining for current to reach the ground is collector, that is through the LED. In this case, LED glows. When we press the button, it activates the base and the maximum current passes through emitter down collector. In this case, the LED does not glow. So this is the live demo of using transistor to demonstrate not logic gate. Next is the OR logic gate. The OR logic gate is a fundamental logic gate in digital circuits, and this gate, as you can see on screen, it produces a high output, which is 1, if any of the inputs are high or all inputs are high. The output is low if and only if all inputs are low, as you can see on screen. This is a schematic diagram for an OR gate using transistor, and it works similar to OR gate using switch. So we need 2 inputs and 1 output device that are buttons and LED, as you can see on screen. So switches are connected in parallel in OR gate using switch, and it's same if we connect transistor in parallel, so that any one of the buttons that gets close, the LED will glow. So any one of the buttons connected to the transistor that gets close, the LED will glow. And here is a breadboard demo of using transistor to demonstrate OR gates. So you can see my breadboard connection of the OR gate using 2 transistors that is connected in parallel. So any of the buttons that get pressed, the LED turns on. If both get pressed, the LED comes on. Next on our basic logic gate is the AND logic gate. The logic AND gate is a type of digital logic circuit whose output goes high to a logic level 1 only when all its inputs are high, as you can see on the table. So when both inputs are 0, the output is 0. When one of the inputs is 0, the output must be 0. So the only condition when the output goes high is when both inputs are 1. That's when the output is 1. This is a schematic diagram for the AND logic gate using transistor. So this is the 3rd basic logic gate, which is the AND gate. So the AND gate using transistor works similar as AND gate using switch. So we also need 2 inputs and 1 output device that are buttons and LED, as you can see on screen. Same way we did when we were trying to build the OR gates, alright, using switches. So the switches are connected in series, as you can see on screen. The switches are connected in series in AND gate using switch. Similar, we are also going to connect the transistor in series. So the transistors are connected in series, so that until both buttons are closed, the LED will not glow. And that works in line with how the AND gate logic works. So until both switches, both buttons are closed, the LED will not glow. And here is a breadboard demo of the AND gate using transistor. So you can see, after pressing one of the buttons, the LED did not glow. So it's waiting until I press both. So when I press both buttons, that is when the condition, which is the 2 inputs is high, that's when the output produces high output. So what is the real life applications of logic gates in embedded systems? So why does this matter for embedded systems? Logic gates help microcontrollers make decisions using sensors and inputs. Think about an Arduino project. A temperature sensor, for instance, reads high and a fan is enabled. That is, fan turns on. Then a motion sensor or a door sensor detects presence, and then an alarm is activated. NOT gate flips logic when needed. So inside this code, these gates become if-else conditions, but the logic stays the same. As you can see, a simple logic turning an electric motor. So here is a quick recap on what we've learned so far. Logic gates are everywhere, from tiny transistors to massive systems. Today, we've learned how to build them using real components, as we've done with using transistors to build various logic gates, and we've seen its application on how it powers decisions in embedded systems. In the next video, we will build a logic gate circuit step by step. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new to this channel. Like this video if you enjoyed this video, and drop your thoughts in the comment section below. Please subscribe to my channel so this video can be recommended. Like this video so it can be recommended to other embedded system enthusiasts or engineers who are interested in embedded systems content. Please click on that subscribe button if you are new to my channel, and like this video. See you in my next video. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.